Chapter 4. Food for Thought. Igor just stood there grinning. Then he turned his head and sniffed. Then he sniffed at Elmer, who was trying to disappear into the chair. Igor turned his head toward the dining room. He sniffed the air once, twice, three times, and each time the smile on his face became bigger and bigger.
Eggplant and tuna surprise, he grunted with happiness.
Igor looked at the table. He saw the food and licked his lips. Elmer sat there and trembled. Igor went over to the table. He ate the eggplant and tuna surprise in one great slurp. He licked his lips again. Then he looked at Elmer in the same way that he had looked at the food. Elmer shut his eyes as tightly as he could. He even shut his mouth. He wrapped his arms around his trembling body. Would this protect him from the evil Igor? He didn't want a black bolt through his neck. Elmer heard footsteps drawing closer and closer. What Elmer needed right now was a superhero. Maybe he could say some magic words. Maybe someone wearing a flowing cape could rescue him and carry him back to the real world. The footsteps stopped. Slowly, he opened his eyes, a little at a time. It wasn't Igor. It was his father, smiling down at him. So what was making him so happy?
You can watch TV again, Elmer, called out his mom. It didn't take you long to finish your dinner. Must have been tasty.
Elmer wasn't sure who had eaten his dinner. He certainly didn't like eggplant and tuna surprise. Now he wasn't so sure that he liked to watch cartoons either. What could he say?
I think I'll go outside for a while, said Elmer to his mom. I think I've had enough TV for one day.
Are you okay? Asked his mother as she looked out at him from the kitchen.
Yes, said Elmer.
But he thought that there are some things that are really strange. So strange that they are too hard to explain.